Hey, y'all. Oh,
hey, everybody. How was everybody doing today?
We good. How you doing?
Very good. Yeah. Today we have a special guest calling in to the Single Ladies Cafe.
Okay.
He is from the new show on TV One, Love Addiction.
Okay.
And he has he's also an author as well too. So he has quite a few hit books that are out right now that we're going to speak to him about. So we might as well just jump right into it.
Okay.
And please welcome Mr. Hassani Pettiford. How are you today, Hassani?
Phenomenal. How are you, Sid?
Very good. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to talk with Little Old Single Ladies Cafe today.
Oh, come on now. You just kind of big.
All right. So, of course, one of the first things that I mentioned is that how I found you was from the new show Love Addiction, which comes on TV One on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. I don't even know where to start because the show, I'm going to tell you, Miss SC and Miss Kiki had not seen the show. I was the first one to see it. And when I was explaining it to them, like, I was getting so mad. Like, I had my fist balled up and everything. And they were like, what are you doing? Is it really that serious? And I'm like, yes, it's that serious. But the only thing that calmed me down was the love expert that was on there. So they actually watched it. And then that's when we said, you know what? Let's reach out to him and see if we can get him on the show. Because I think he's a good fit for the Single Ladies Cafe.
Absolutely.
Can you speak about how you were offered, you know, the opportunity to be a part of the Love Addiction show?
Well, for the last 14 years, I've actually been a professional speaker and author and coach, and have been traveling all over the nation, really, dealing with male-female interpersonal relationships, human sexuality, personal growth, development. I've done a lot of radio. And so when they were seeking out experts for the show, they basically Googled me. They didn't Google me. They were Googling relationship experts and those that they think would be an appropriate fit. And they came across my work and gave me a call. And so I answered the call, and here we are today.
Wow, that's really awesome. That's incredible. It's you, and then there are, is it one other expert or two that's a part of the show?
So you have Dr. Aldwan Tart, who's out of Atlanta. And you also have Dr. Tama Bryant, who's out of California.
And that's Pastor Jamal Bryant's sister, is that correct?
Absolutely.
All right. Yeah, that's a good panel. They're doing a good thing over there. Kudos to TV One.
And, you know, and to speak to that point, I really am proud of TV One because, you know what, there's so many reality shows out today that are just gutter, that are just trash, that show the worst of who we are. But TV One, you know, took the opportunity to do something creative, to give people a form of entertainment, but to also provide a teachable moment for those that do, regardless of their relational status.
Right, that's a good thing. And kudos to TV One again, because there's not enough of that going around, and I hope that a lot of the other networks would pick up and do this something towards the same and give us a little bit more of a positive reality TV.
Absolutely.
That's going on. So the episode that I saw, and I'm not going to stay on Love Addiction because we got, you know, you have other things that you do too, but the episode that I first saw was the one with Bryant. Now, he was, like, I mean, off the hook. And I was like, is he serious right now? Like, when he first started off, he's like, oh, I love her. That's my boo. And then when he got into that intervention with you and you started questioning him and he just got really nasty. Like, it was just like, is this guy serious? But what I love the most is how you're, like, so cool and you're so calm. And you just throw the right questions out at them. Mm, and you don't get upset. Mm. And you actually make them see what they're doing wrong. So, with Bryant, like, how did you feel? Like, did you want to jump across and snatch him up?
The tension was thick. I mean, you could cut it with a knife. And what's interesting, most people don't know this, there's security in the room every single time we have an intervention. So, you know, he's posing as a cameraman, but if anything were to go down, he would jump in and just handle it.
Oh, okay.
Like a double black belt. So that seemed to really go down that we didn't want to go down. But you could see the rage, the fury, the anger in his eyes as I penetrated him with certain questions that basically put him out and exposed him before the entire world for who he really is.
Wow.
And my whole thing about it is, you know, you have so many men out here that are taking advantage of women, that are abusing women, that are cheating on women, and just disrespecting them, and then abandoning them. And so women have to be better in terms of the choices that they make, because there's so many fools yes. that disguise themselves as good men mm-hmm. that destroy a woman's life.
Absolutely, absolutely. So who was the other one that they had? It was the young man that was dating the washed up Vegas dancer.
Oh, Marcus and Susie.
Yes, oh, that was. Goodness. Now, she ended up leaving and going back to her husband. Is that correct?
That is true. And you know what is interesting? Because as you watch that television episode unfold, there's so much that they don't show you. Mm-hmm. Like, just understand, the intervention is literally an hour to an hour and a half long, and then it's shrunk down into about an 8-minute, you know, video or sound bite. Mm-hmm. So you only get a glimpse of what actually takes place. And so in that intervention, so many other issues have come out in terms of why it was best for him to leave her. And he ultimately made the decision to do it, but he was vacillating back and forth and was still unsure. But we knew eventually it was going to end because this is a woman who's married to another man, mm-hmm. right? Yep. But still technically connected to Marcus, and it was a dead-end relationship. And so it's funny. I wish that the show was more than an hour so we could really capture right. things that the audience didn't get a chance to see.
Right. That's what I was going to say. I was going to ask you, do you know if they're going to actually put any episodes out where it would show a little bit more what they couldn't show, or do they actually show it on the website? Do you know?
No, you know, unfortunately, on the website, they show snippets or little commercials of each show or even the full episode, but there's nothing beyond that. But what they will be showing, which I don't know why they haven't released yet, all of the experts had an opportunity to answer a list of questions about relationships, you know, dating, married, single, you know, what's the player, how do you find a good man, you know, all types of questions. Mm. And the answers are just phenomenal. I don't know when they're going to release that, but I think that that will be a very, very, very valuable piece for people to really tap into on a website.
Oh, that's awesome. I'm looking forward to that because I every time I watch it, I'm like, ooh. Like, I know they say that they give a little update towards the end. What's the time span from when they actually did the, like, show and then they had the intervention with you and then they kind of give us an update? Is that something where it's like a month or two or, like, you know, after that they give that update?
Literally after the intervention takes place and the couple either parts or goes their separate ways or whatever they decide to do.
Oh.
So, you know, we check in on them 3 weeks later.
Okay.
Find out where they're at. And then, just so you know, every couple is offered professional counseling as a result of the show.
Oh, that's
awesome.
So, just
leave them where they're at. We really do try to go above and beyond to assist them through the process because breaking up is a hard process.
Right. Okay. Now, last one on Love Addiction, and then we'll move on. Now, there's a marathon tonight at 8 p.m., correct?
Yes.
So it's going to show 4 of the episodes that you guys have had, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, are there going to be any more new, or the 4 that we've seen, is that it for the season?
Oh, no. Actually, there are 9 episodes. Oh. Okay, so you've only seen 4. There are 8 episodes, I believe. I'm in 4 of them, and then the others are split up by the other 2 experts. So after this week, you're going to see brand new episodes that you haven't seen before. So, in essence, I'm kind of passing the baton because the majority of them are going to be Dr. Tart, Dr. Tama, and I have 1 of those 4 that will be coming up.
Okay, good. We want to see more Hasani.
So hopefully we can have a 6th season.
All right, cool. I think whatever we have to do to make sure that it's 2, if we have to sign a petition, something, I'll make sure that I'll be the person to start that and get that going.
My sister.
That's what's up. Okay, so moving on, I did mention that you are an author.
Yeah.
You have some of the books that you have is Why We Hate Black Women, and what's the rest of that title?
It's entitled Why We Hate Black Women and Why We Should Love Them.
Okay.
Yeah, finish that title.
And then we have Black Thighs, Black Guys, and Bedroom Lies.
Yes.
And then we have Pimping from the Pulpit to the Pews. And then you have how many more? 7 other books, is it?
Yeah, I've written a ton of books.
Okay. So I'm pretty sure that those have done very well for you. Unfortunately, I have not gotten a chance to read any of them because when I went to go order them, some guy was selling your book for like $134 on Amazon. I was like, well, go ahead now. I only have $134 because I got to pay for this cruise coming up. But I
would encourage everybody to go to my website at hasani.com. You can purchase the book for $14.95. I think Why We Hate Black Women is $16.95.
Okay.
But tonight for the marathon, we have a special going on. And if anybody purchases Why We Hate Black Women and Why We Should Love Them, they're also going to get 2 additional books of my choice for free just for support the show and support me as one of the relationship experts.
Ooh, nice. That's awesome. That's a good deal. So if you watch the show, you order a book, then you get two free out of your collection for the price of one. That's good. That's really good. You can't beat that. So we'll make sure that we go on Facebook and we promote that competition. Is that when does that end? Is that only for today?
That is only for today. That will end at midnight tonight. And it kind of leads me to another thing I'm working on, but I'll wait to bring any other issues up before I go there.
All right. So just to I'm just going to go, you know, name the couple of the books that I've already listed off. And if you can just give us a little quick rundown of what the books entail, that would be nice. So we'll start with Why We Hate Black Women.
Well, I wrote Why We Hate Black Women and Why We Should Love Them because I was sick and tired of every single time I watched a YouTube video or read a blog or turned on the television and watched the news report or read an article in a newspaper or magazine. All I was reading was this hatred towards black women. Mm-hmm. And so the question that I ask in the book is, why is it that we hate black women? And so many people make the assumption that the we that I'm talking about in the title is black men. Mm-hmm. But that is not necessarily the case. Though there are black men who have a hatred towards black women, we're also talking about why some black women hate themselves, mm-hmm. why some women hate on other women, why the general white culture and society has had this hatred towards black women, the media hatred towards black women, hip-hop's hatred towards black women. There has been a long legacy of 390 years of hatred and aggression towards black women, and so we have all been willing participants in that particular act. So this book comes from a relational perspective, a social perspective, a historical perspective. It is one of the most powerful books that I ever have written. It is a great book. I'm not saying that because I read it too. Mm-hmm. And everyone who reads it loves it.
Awesome. So we're wait, can I be qualified for that contest that you have tonight?
Well, if you get that order in by midnight tonight,
all right,
you will receive your book for two free of my choice. Absolutely.
All right. Awesome. So the next book, we'll go to Pimpin' from the Pulpit to the Pews. What about that one?
Well, I'm born and raised in a church. And so, you know, it's interesting. I wrote Black Thighs before that. Now, let me just go back to Black Thighs for a second.
Okay.
The reason why I wrote Black Thighs is because there's a whole lot of bitterness and pain and resentment and animosity, just mistrust and hate between black men and women as a result of all the sexual games and the bedlines that we play with one another in relationships. And see, a game is competitive in nature. So whether you're watching, I don't know, baseball or basketball, soccer, football, wrestling, whatever the sport may be, there's always someone who wins and someone who loses. Mm-hmm. But anytime you take this game concept, which is very competitive in nature, and then try to put it within the confines of a relationship, which, you know, it produces a problem. And so many people have been abused and all messed up as a result of poor relationships and poor sexual decisions. And as a result of that book, so many people in the church read it and said, Asani, the issues you're talking about in this book also take place in the church. Mm-hmm. That's just absolutely right. So in this book, From the Pulpit to the Pews, we talk about sex in the church. We cover every aspect that you could possibly imagine, from the pulpit to the pews.
All right.
Mm-hmm. All right. Go ahead and preach.
I know for a minute. I was going to say, woo!
Wow.
All three of the books sound incredible. And I'm pretty sure the other seven are just as good.
Yeah.
So I'm definitely going to put my order in tonight by midnight. And I encourage everybody else that's watching to do the same. I just have to say, like, this is a great experience for us because you're so humble. And when we reached out to you, it was just, yeah, no problem. Let's do it. It wasn't any pulling any teeth. And in the celebrity world, it's kind of hard. So I just want to take that moment to just say thank you.
Well, I appreciate that. You know, I was always taught that your talent can never take where your integrity cannot keep you. And I've always been taught to be humble because it's individuals like you and your support that allow me to do what I'm doing. And at any time that I flip the script and get big-headed and high-minded, then that's when I lose the position that I'm in. And so I have a working relationship with everybody, fans, followers, experts such as yourself, because there's so much room at the top, and why not us all come together and do what we need to do to change people's lives?
Mm-hmm. All right. That brings me into the relationship cruise. Yeah, we
can't wait.
We cannot wait.
We're excited. Like, is we over here already shopping and everything. So we do have a cruise, the relationship cruise, which is going to Nassau, Bahamas in October 12th through the 15th. It is something that you had originally already had going on, and you have a few other groups that are also participating, but you did reach out to us and say, hey, why don't you guys participate in this cruise? And again, we thank you, you know. Just to give a little information on what that cruise is all about to the audience.
Well, October the 12th through the 15th, we're going to be leaving out of Miami, Florida, and going to Nassau, Bahamas for 3 days. We're sailing for two. We're docked for one. And we have a whole lot of activities. And so I'm telling you, if people are excited about it, not only because of the fact that we're going to do a lot of relationship things, which I'll get to in a second, but the price is just amazing. Oh, could you imagine going away on an international vacation for $300? I mean, $300. Plus, we have a $100 registration fee, which will give you access to all of our events. So this is a relationship cruise for singles as well as couples. So if you're single and you're dating or you're seeking someone, we're going to have love connection, and we're going to have speed dating and relationship panels for singles. And we're going to have like a, I think there's the organization out of Atlanta that puts on a very powerful like war of the sexes type of debate, man versus, it's incredible. We're going to have a white party dinner and dance. We're going to have comedy. We're going to have all types of events. If you're in a relationship, if you're married, we're going to have marriage seminars. We're going to have a vow renewal ceremony, which is going to be fantastic. There's so many things that we have to accommodate individuals that are seeking healthy relationships. And everybody who gets on this boat will get a complimentary 30-minute counseling or coaching session with either me, Hassani Pettiford, or one of the other experts that will be on this cruise as well. So it's going to be a phenomenal time. We encourage everybody to come out. It's going to be an experience that you do not want to forget. You do not want to miss.
I agree. That sounds good. It makes me, I want to go now.
That's what I'm talking about.
And then do you have a contest for that as well? If you book your cruise tonight, that also runs into the Love Addiction Marathon that you have going on tonight?
For those individuals that stay with me for 4 hours from 8 p.m. to midnight p.m. Eastern Standard Time, if you purchase the book that I mentioned earlier, Why We Hate Black Women and Why We Should Love Them, and you will get two additional books, as we know, but the other thing is you will qualify for a free trip on board the Carnival Imagination on our way to the Bahamas. So if any of you who are affiliated with the Single Ladies Cafe, you know, register and get your book, you will be able to qualify potentially to get on this book free. And so it's amazing to be able to get a free trip for the possibility of purchasing a book for $16.95. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know anybody who would do that.
I don't know either, but thank you, God, for you. So that pretty much is, you know, going to wrap up our interview. Once again, I thank you so much for taking the time out to chit-chat with us and update us and give our audience an idea of who you are. That's why we wanted you to call in today. I would like in future, if possible, if we can kind of sort of sometimes maybe use you for an advice type of situation on the Single Ladies Cafe every now and then when we need a little help.
Absolutely, sis. I mean, this is my passion. This is my heart. Whenever you call me, I'll be available. I can give advice. We can talk about the content of some of these books that have really been a blessing to people. Call on me. You know I'm here. You know my name. You know my number. This is what we do. Let's make it happen.
Awesome. We appreciate it. Miss SC, do you have something that you wanted to say?
I just want to say, hi, Hassani.
Hi, sis. How are you?
I'm good. I just want to say to the audience that tonight we'll be watching, and one of the things that we've been doing is we've been going over to our fan page and we've been having a dialogue, so you guys can come on and kind of watch the show with us and put your two cents in and just kind of enjoy the show with us. Some people, the first time we did it, we were like, I don't think anybody's watching because only a few people were responding as usual. But then we found out, I think last week we kind of posted something about somebody came on and said, "What show are you guys watching?" And somebody that we didn't even know came on and posted, "They're watching Love Addiction." And I was like, oh, so they are watching us, you know. Right. So I just want to encourage people that are in the audience or anybody that's a part of the Single Ladies Cafe to please just kind of come on, log on, have a good time. I got to go home and eat, so I'll probably be like eating while I'm watching the show. And then, you know, it's fun to hear what other people have to say, other people's opinions. Mm-hmm. And I mean, this is an awesome, awesome show. So I want to really promote it, and I really want to encourage people to watch it, because those of you that have been following us for a very long time, you know that pretty much these are the same topics that we talk about here in the Single Ladies Cafe. And it's just wonderful to be able to see someone who is a little more ahead of us on TV1 doing what we always talk about. So stay tuned. We got a lot more coming up.
Absolutely. And Hassani, before we let you go, can you just let our audience know how they can get a hold of you?
You can go to my website, which is very simple. It's www.hassani.com. That's H-A-S-A-N-I, Hassani.com. Or you can find me on Facebook. Just type in Hassani Pettiford and we can connect.
All right, awesome. Well, thank you for taking your time out to speak to us. We will see you when we board that cruise.
Absolutely.
And you have a good night, and we will, of course, keep in contact.
I appreciate you.
Yes, thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you, Hassani.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye.